Welcome to Impactful Teens, a podcast dedicated to helping teens create an impactful and God-honoring life by developing a fulfilling and meaningful career. Each episode is 5 to 10 minutes of inspiration, motivation, and practical applications to design your life and career in a way that positively impacts the world around you. Today I'm answering an audience question. And it goes something like this. Would you, if you had the opportunity and knew what the end goal was, would you take a roundabout path towards getting there? And he went into some detail, and what he's doing is looking at building his own business. He's changing states and looking at building his own business, but he had a job opportunity in a third state, not the one he wants to move to and not the one that he lives in, but he wanted to take this job opportunity to save up some money and to learn kind of about the business side of things, because this job was the same type of business that he's looking to start in the state that he's moving to. A little bit complicated situation, but he said, what would you do in this situation? And my answer to him was this. I went ahead and replied to his question, but my answer was this. If you know what your end goal is, and taking that roundabout path helps you to gain necessary skills and knowledge and some insight into that type of business, because that other job working for somebody else is in the same line of work as the business that you're wanting to start in the other state, then yes, that lines up with your goals. That's something that you can go ahead and do. That fits in with what you want in life. On the plus side too, it was a really well-paying job, so he would be able to perhaps pay off some debt, hopefully get completely out of debt, save up some money, and be able to go into his new business debt-free because he would have enough money saved up to start his other business. So yeah, that's a great model to go after. That's a great thing to do, is think of it as a work study rather than going off to college and trying to figure out what it is that you want to do while you're in school. He knows what he's going after, and he's kind of apprenticing, but getting paid really well to do it, in the same type of business that he wants to start. So that fits really well with his life plan. On the other hand, if it's something that doesn't fit in with your life plan, then you would really want to take a deep look at what the benefits are of taking that job in the other state, not the one that you ultimately plan to move to, and make sure that you would be able to save away a bunch of your income, save that money without going farther into debt. My wife and I had an opportunity very similar to this a couple of years back, and we jumped on it. Perhaps we shouldn't have, because it was a slightly different situation. We had moved out of the state that we got married in and lived in for nearly 10 years. We moved from Georgia to Kentucky, and the opportunity was to move back to Georgia, and my wife could teach school indefinitely if she wanted to. And I had still had a lot of contacts from my construction business that I had run in Georgia. So we looked at it as an opportunity to save that money, because we planned on coming back to Kentucky to the homestead that we lived on and were starting. We thought it would be an opportunity to save a bunch of money to jumpstart our goals. It didn't quite work out that way. There were some things that happened, some unforeseen events that took away a lot of the money that we had worked for that 2.5 years that we were back in Georgia. So in the end, we were no farther ahead having done that than if we had stayed in Kentucky the whole time and not gone back to Georgia. Yes, we built some relationships. There were some pluses to it, definitely. But just looking back on the financial side of it, it was the wrong decision to make. And I was talking with a friend here a while back who was faced with a similar situation as this. She said, went for the money. I had this position. I wanted to quit. They threw more money at it. And I said, okay, I'll stay there for a year. She ended up staying there for 8 years. And instead of saving the money, came out with a bunch of debt. So you need to know your life plan before you make a decision like this. If that position, if the alternate route fits in and ultimately helps you to get to your life plan, your life goal quicker, then yes, go for it. Dive into it. Do it. I'd highly encourage that. But you need to know how it fits in and what the benefits are, how it could alter your life plan, how things might change, and have some contingencies in place for if things don't go how you expect them to go. That's all I've got for you today. As always, stay focused on your mission, remain steadfast in your pursuit of excellence, and always do the right thing.